Hello everyone, I'm back. I hope you didn't miss me too much whilst I had my week away. I have returned refreshed and reinvigorated by my holiday reading and really excited as well about some of the books we've got coming up over the next month or so. Before I get to them, I must of course reveal who won last book of the week. That was Death and Mr. Pickwick by Stephen Jarvis, and that copy was won by Dazar. Or Dazza HR, you know who you are anyway. Dazza, if you look at the bottom of this video, you'll find my email address. Please send me your postal address and I'll get that book off to you straight away. Now, I only managed to read a couple of books whilst I was away, but they were both brilliant. And the first of those is Rachel Cusk's Outline, which we published in paperback, has been shortlisted for many awards already. And it's just a fabulous, brilliant book. It's the kind of book that I'm going to completely fail to do justice to in a short video like this, but I will try. That is because it is sort of not complex. It really just gets to the nub of what it is to be a human being, which of course is quite a complex thing. Not dealt with in a very complex manner, if you see what I mean. She's just fiercely honest, and I'm getting ahead of myself. I should start at the beginning. You will notice that it almost looks a bit like the sea and a beach on this cover, and it is indeed about a woman who travels to Greece to teach on a writing course. But this is no sort of Shirley Valentine tale. This is about a woman who is sort of not revealing very much about herself in this book, but what we get to hear are the stories of the people that she meets. The man that she sits next to on the plane, the friend that she meets out there, the students on her course. They tell her, I guess, the stories of their life. And I use the word stories very deliberately because what we all do, I think, when we tell people about ourselves is engage in a level of storytelling because we choose what to reveal about ourselves. We might be putting a slightly positive gloss on our lives, certainly on ourselves. And that means that we're not strictly telling the truth. We are telling a story. And that's what all of these people do. They tell a sort of version of themselves, a narrative. And that's what this book is sort of about at its very core, about how we have this sort of need to put a narrative sort of skin over our lives and how we choose to leave out certain parts or, as I said, put a certain gloss on things in order to portray ourselves in a particular way. As I said, we don't get to know much about the sort of narrator, but I do know for a fact that Rachel Cusk taught on a writing course in Greece. And in fact, when I spoke about this book on Twitter a few nights ago, a few writers jumped up and sort of said how much they love the book, but also that they had been in Greece on this same writing course. One of them had actually stayed in the flat that is mentioned. And so you wonder how much of this is based on fact or how much of it is fiction. And that's where I'm going to draw a parallel with Carl Ove Knausgård, who I know Rachel Cusk is a big fan of, and you can see the influence of him and a few other writers too. Another review that I saw had mentioned W.G. Sebald as another influence, and it is that intersection of fact and fiction which is really, really fascinating. It's not really important, I don't think, in terms of enjoyment of the book. It doesn't matter whether any or all of this was real, but it's that sort of line that's blurred that makes it really sort of exciting and interesting to read. And the reason why it's invigorating to read, I saw another review which said that it was a lethally intelligent novel, and I wondered what on earth that actually meant before I started reading it. And after finishing it, I have a better understanding. It is intelligent because she is supremely intelligent and she is really looking head on at what it means to be human and how we conduct ourselves and the complex psychologies behind our everyday interactions. It's lethal because that's a really difficult thing to engage with. And I was thinking of another writer when I was reading it, which is Samuel Beckett, who was never, of course, afraid of looking at what it means to be human and to face up to the possible uselessness of that existence or how empty it might be, but also, of course, the redemptive quality of that when you kind of go through that thought process. This is what we mean by lethal intelligence. This is what we mean by fabulously complex reading experiences. And there are so many more things that I could say about this book, and which I haven't got time for, and you probably haven't got time for either. But I would love if people do read this book to leave comments underneath this video to carry the discussion further, because in my short chat on Twitter the other day, we had lots of things to say. It was all really, really interesting. So Rachel Cusk's Outline is well worth your time. A fantastic read. Very, very provocative and very, very exciting. In complete contrast, we have Butcher's Crossing by John Williams. John Williams, of course, wrote Stoner, which has become a sort of famous book over the last couple of years, a rediscovered classic. And John Williams is a fascinating writer because we published three of his books and they're all completely different. Stoner is a tale of sort of repressed and very quiet dignity and intelligence about a man's life. And Butcher's Crossing is very different in that it is about a man travelling through sort of the wilds of Colorado at the time of, you know, not quite the Wild West, but, you know, this is a time of buffalo hunting and skins and muskets and rifle shot and all that kind of stuff. And it is about as macho and testosterone-fueled a book as you can imagine. But I don't mean that in a loud sense, because, again, Williams has this real restraint with his writing, which is fascinating to read as you go through. So that this book, which, as I say, is about a young man hooking up with a few others and going right out into the wilds, into the mountains of Colorado to hunt buffalo, to hunt a massive herd of buffalo that have been sort of protected by their environment and therefore are much older than the type of young skins that hunters have been catching usually. And the sort of the very basic hardships that they face on a simple journey like that, and then how much harder those hardships become once they encounter adversity, let's say. The description of the environment and the description of what they're doing is brilliantly handled. The sort of ease with which they take on the chest the awful situations that they find themselves in, the brutality and the sort of evisceration that occurs, and the difficulty of surviving a winter in the mountains, all of these things make it a stunning and quite involving read. And I don't want to give away too much of the plot, but as I said, there is hardship, and the way in which these stoical men have to take those things is brilliantly handled by Williams. I really enjoyed it. It's a completely different book to Stoner, and I believe his third novel, which of course I will now get to, Augustus, which is about a Roman emperor, will be completely different too. But what an amazing writer to have written three very distinct novels, which are very different in their setting, particularly in time, but I would suspect all are united by this sort of very calm and reserved approach to the writing, which actually makes them all the more interesting and impactful. So there we go. That is Butcher's Crossing by John Williams. As I said, a couple of books that I really, really enjoyed. There are even more exciting books coming up in the next month or so, and I will have something hopefully for you next week, which will be a proper, genuine, exclusive giveaway. But this week's giveaway will be, as I said, copies of Outline. I have got four copies of Rachel Cusk's Outline to give away. If you would like one, subscribe, leave a comment below this video, and I'll pick four winners next week. That is all for this week. I'll see you next week. Take care. Bye-bye.